I am Vizak Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Pause Play here at Stingray Music with Montreal's own Busty in the Bass, where we talk car crashes, Google search histories, and an upcoming album. Tune in right now.
Hi, we're Busty in the Bass, and you're watching Stingray's Pause Play.
Welcome to the show, Busty in the Bass. How are you boys doing?
Great.
Good.
Why don't you introduce yourselves, tell us what you guys do in the band.
I'm Nick. I sing and play saxophone.
I am Alistair Blue. I rap and play synthesizers.
Good combo.
I'm Eric. I play keyboards.
Louis. I like to make guitar sound weird.
Dope. You guys met at McGill. You guys were all studying music. Tell me how you guys came together to form the band.
Sort of just the craze of first week at McGill, and by chance and by circumstance, we ended up in the same house playing for about 200 people, having just met each other that night, and got pretty drunk, not going to lie. Woke up the next day, and Busty and the Bass was written on a napkin.
On a napkin?
Yeah.
It's where the best stuff's written.
Exactly.
It's where the best stuff's written. What's the best part for you guys about being able to spend this last year just playing the music that you love with, I assume, the dudes that you love?
For me, just not having...
Or strongly like is fine, too.
Not having to deal with school and just having the freedom to make music whenever we want, however we want, is my favorite part about it.
Yeah, I've really enjoyed all the traveling we've been able to do. Just like playing music for new people in new places has been really, really cool.
Do you have a favorite place you guys have been able to go to?
Me personally, I was really happy to go to Calgary because that's where I'm from. And it's kind of cool. We've been to all of our hometowns, all nine of them. And it's always a different but very important experience.
Awesome. You guys kind of first gained notoriety when you won Rock Your Campus. It was just over a year ago now. We have a very special question from a very good friend of Stingray's Pause Play show and a ghost from your past.
Busty in the Bass. How's it going, fellas? It's Max. I hope you're doing great. My question for you is, what is a popular song that, you know, we all would know that actually is a little tricky for you guys to play?
It depends what you define as pop, because...
Well, I'm going to leave that up to you, my friend.
Because, I mean, like, to cover, like, a Michael Jackson song can have its difficulties in many ways, arranging. And singing for Nick is always an interesting one. What key are we going to play?
Was that an insult?
In?
Did he just totally
just
insult
slightly,
you?
Just slightly.
I think he did.
But I'll roll with it, you know.
Hey, we got to just keep moving around here.
Do you guys have a favorite song to cover? I mean, I was mentioning to you guys before, your Latch Disclosure cover is phenomenal.
That's
I
actually
love
pretty hard.
One.
That's pretty hard. Like, electronic covers are often difficult because everything's quantized on a grid.
Yeah.
But you have, like, Eric playing it on keyboards with Louis in unison on guitar, like little things that Disclosure just put into the computer. So, I mean, that's always difficult trying to get that across. But
yeah, it's tough to cover the electronic tracks because, like, you know, the producers that make those can, you know, they have unlimited layers and effects and they can, like, take their time and make sure that everything sounds exactly right. And we have nine people. That's a lot of layers. But we can't exactly, like, take our time during shows to mimic everything exactly right. So getting the sounds on those right is tough.
The EP Glam is you can get free on your site, bustingthebass.com. You guys are with Indica now. When can we expect a full album release from you guys?
So the great part of us being out of school right now is we're going to be recording all winter, pretty much. We just had about a week in the studio, then we're taking some time off for the holidays. All winter, it's going to be really, really fun. And then singles will be coming out through the spring and summer and likely dropping the album beginning of the fall. So
it's
really excited.
It's hard enough to write and arrange and practice with like a three-piece band. How do you guys manage to do it with a nine-piece? What are some tips and tricks? How do you arrange? How do you practice? How do you perform and not kill each other?
I think that it actually turns out to be easier once you figure out how it works, because you can just make more tracks. Rather than squeezing nine ideas into one, why not make nine tracks and you have an album sooner than you know it?
That's a good answer. That's a good answer. So a band like Bad Bad Not Good doing an album with Ghostface Killa, you know, that's such an interesting concept. Is there an artist that you guys would love to do a concept album with?
I'm sure there are many, but I can't think of any right now. What about you, Nick?
All of them.
All of them. Okay.
All pretty great.
Okay. Every single artist.
Just every single artist.
I would buy that album, I think. I feel like it'd be a really terrific, or it could be really terrible album as well.
I would love to do some collaborations with a female vocalist. I don't necessarily know who But I think that'd be a really sick sound to get in our stuff.
I'm getting ripped today, man.
You're getting ripped, bro. They do not like you as a singer in this band at all.
No, okay. Nick can hit those notes with his falsetto, man. Come on.
You can do it. I believe in you, Nick. I believe in you. I heard that you guys have gotten out of some vehicle-related mishaps using the excuse of horns in your band. Tell me a bit about what on earth you're talking about.
A couple times. One, we got in like a little Fender. I won't even call it a Fender Bender. I'll call it a Fender Grazer. And an angry woman gets out of the car, and then calls her husband, who was upstairs in their apartment, to come down. This was in New York City, and you know we're getting the
friendliest city in the world.
The traditional New York grilling. The husband comes down with like two of his friends that he was with. So we got about four people. And we're getting grilled, and like it's the usual, what would you expect from like getting a little mishap with someone in New York? And then things started to sort of cool off, and they noticed that the plates were from Quebec, and they're like, well, what are you guys doing here? And I'm just like, yeah, where's musicians, Quebec? And just like, yeah, like I pointed to Mike and I was just like, yeah, like we play horns, and then just instantly it's just like, whoa, horn players in town? And it's like, where are you guys playing? And like we're talking about maybe coming to our show later.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, and a couple speeding tickets where we just dropped the line, we're banned, nine of us, four horns. The four horns is just kind of a weird little something triggers in people's brains. They're like, wow, these guys must make no money. So I got to help them out.
That's really sad.
With a misdemeanor. Yeah.
And they're right.
That's really sad. We asked the last artist that we had in to ask you guys a question. Here's that question.
Hey, this is Joey from the Brothers Landreth, and my question for you is, what are the last three things to come up in your Google search?
Probably the most recent for me, as of this morning, was the best new sampling technology.
Okay, I'll take it.
It's only one, though.
Yeah. I think I was looking up some mulled wine recipes, planning going home for the holidays.
Holiday season.
But right after this, my most recent one after this interview will be how to make my bandmates respect me as a singer. So that'll be great.
I don't know what I searched last. I think I was searching for some crazy electronic like synthesizer sound called Mutations from the 1960s. So that's about it.
That was pretty sick.
I was trying to organize a ski trip this morning, so I'm trying to figure out if I can get tickets for cheaper, and I'm not having much luck.
Sorry, bro. Sorry about that. What are some great Canadian bands that you guys love right now that people should go check out?
If you guys haven't heard of Drake, he's Canadian.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah.
He's cool.
It sounds like a ska band. Who is that?
Yeah, it's ska.
Yep.
Drake, you brought up Bad. We love what they do.
Great band.
It's always wicked.
Yeah, I've been checking out a lot of Grimes lately as well. I'm sure you've heard of her, but
I have also heard of Grimes, yeah. She's a ska band as well, right?
Exactly.
A lot of ska bands you guys
all
are
ska.
Into.
More
all
like
ska.
Modern ska.
Yeah, okay, cool. Oh, just Canadian ska all the way. I like it. Okay, that's fine. I'll have to have them on the show. It's good. You can hear Busty and the Bass on Stingray Music's Canadian Indie Channel. You listening? Have you listened to that channel? Have you listened to that channel?
Every day of
Every
my life.
Every day is the right question. It's a great channel. Don't forget to tune in and check out the Stingray Music mobile application and check out our new Vibes feature with over 1,000 new channels where you can play with era, genre, activity, and mood. Thanks so much for stopping by, guys.
Thank you.
You
going
to play some music for us?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, okay, all right, okay, fine. Tune in next time. Hey everybody, thanks for watching. Click on the left to subscribe to Pause Play. Click on the right to watch more videos.